As they panic over demography and immigration, Europe's theorists are well aware of this. Hence the difficulty of, for instance, the current European debate over Turkey's application for membership of the European Union. The Erdogan government presents liberals with a paradox. Less secular than its predecessors, it is more committed to human rights and democratic pluralism, and is keen in particular to curb the military's projection in the political realm. The generals, with their tight-lipped laicism, claim to be the guardians of Ataturk's project to recreate Turkey in Europe's image, yet Europe has moved on. It's no longer the nationalistic, often fascistic continent that it was in the 1920s and 30s when Kemalism took shape. Hence the conundrum for the Eurocrats. Many European liberal statesmen, particularly in France and Germany, oppose Turkish membership on grounds that are clearly to do with Europe's ancient habit of self-definition as something that ultimately is not Muslim. Europe may be economically inclusive and passionately liberal and libertarian, but ultimately, to be itself, it needs to be exclusive of Muslims above all. The old crusading cry of Christians are right and pagans are wrong has been modified by replacing the word Christians with gay activists and human rights commissioners. Now, it's not impossible that in the end Turkey will be admitted, perhaps after several decades. But the current proposals which are on the table envisage Turkey's exclusion from the Amsterdam Treaty in respect of Turkey's Muslim population. In other words, if you're a European and you want to go and live in Turkey, you will have that right. But if you're a Turk and you want to go and live in Hamburg, you won't have the ability to do that. Those are the terms which are now being proposed to Ankara.